As long as it has been an automaker on this planet, Mitsubishi has made some pretty interesting cars. The old Eclipse was very cool. The Diamond Star Motors era of just turbocharged all-wheel drive fun. Now the Evo is a blast. It's one of the most fun cars you can drive on the planet. This though, this isn't one of those cars. This is the 2013 Lancer SE, and I don't love it. Now, obviously, they cannot make this as aggressive as the Lancer Evolution. That's a totally different beast, and I know not to expect that with the standard Lancer. Still, you've got the Mitsubishi snout, which looks good. It's, again, not as aggressive. You've got the sharp cut headlamps. You've got a little bit of character in the hood. These wheels are all right. They're a little on the drab side. You've got the shoulder line, and you've got the rear end like you would get on an Evo, but there's nothing super special going on here. It's sporty for the segment, but only just. So here is where this car gets its motivation. This is a 2.4 liter inline four cylinder engine, and it produces 168 horsepower and 167 pound feet of torque, and it's not enough. The car is a little bit sluggish. It has a surprisingly decent engine note, which I like, but it's paired also with the CVT, so you're not going to extract more from it like you could with a manual, and it's a combination that is looking for fuel economy, but we are in maybe the low 20 mile per gallon range at best, and in this segment, you need to be way higher than that. Everything else is pushing into the 30s, some are touching 40. Maybe not at this price point though. This car as it sits is $22,000. That's because it's hiding a little bit secret. This is the SE AWC. AWC stands for all wheel control. So you can use this engine and send power to all four wheels. Additionally, you can shut that off and just do front wheel drive, or you can even put it into a four wheel drive lock mode, which, you know, when you go off roading in your Lancer SE, it's perfect. So what do you get on the inside of the Lancer for $22,000? Not much. That's the same story though if you climb all the way up to the Evolution. That car is just about driving, and I really shouldn't compare the two, but they are cut from the same mold. With that car, you get one of the greatest powertrains on the planet with one of the worst interiors. Here, you're just left with a mediocre powertrain and the same crap interior. You've got a decent little display in the center stack. They did a good job there with colors, and it looks nice, and there's a lot of info, but the center area here is bland. The Rockford Fosgate sound system does sound good. You've got a nice sunroof. You've got the button here to change the drive modes, but there's not a lot going on, and there's not a lot to get excited about. There are better options out there right now. This car needs to be overhauled majorly so it can compete with the rest of the segment, because it's got to be towards the bottom of the pack. When you hop into most cars in this segment, you know what you're getting into. It's going to be sporty, it's going to be a fuel efficient car, it's going to have great features. Here, it's a little bit of a mixed bag. You've got a pseudo sporty exterior, and you've got a much bigger brother, more powerful sibling that you can have visions of pretending that you're going to be driving a car like that. That's not the case. What you wind up with the Lancer SE is a car that I think the SE kind of stands for sad edition.